Finally, crypto mining is slowing down. Howdy howdy guys, Ponchato here, and welcome to monthly builds for April of 2018. In these videos, I show you the parts I'd use for building gaming PCs at $500, $750, and $1,000 budgets. To keep up with new prices and components, I put up a new video every month, so be sure to subscribe to stay up to date. Before we get to the builds, we'll take a look at some industry news. First, as I mentioned at the beginning, it seems that cryptocurrency mining is on its way out, or at least down. GPU prices are still above MSRP, but they are much lower now than they were just a few months ago, which is fantastic. Finally. In addition to that, SSD prices seem to have dropped a bit, so now might actually be the best time to build a PC in recent memory. Let's hope these prices continue to drop. Intel released the remainder of their Coffee Lake desktop CPUs, mostly in the lower Celeron and Pentium Gold chips. The one that caught my attention is the G5400, which looks to be the successor to the fantastically received G4560. On top of that, the lower-priced H310, B360, and H370 chipset motherboards are starting to become available. Whereas before we were limited to only using the $100+ Z370 boards, now we should start seeing Coffee Lake motherboards for as low as about $60. Will Coffee Lake successfully take on the budget market? An upcoming video may just answer that question, hint hint. Lastly, later this month, AMD is set to release the rest of the Ryzen 2000 series CPUs. The upcoming models represent a small thinning of the lineup compared to the original Ryzen launch, with the 2000 series only having 6 models instead of 9. Two of them, the 2200G and 2400G, are already out, and in a few weeks we'll see the remaining 4, the Ryzen 5 2600, 2600X, Ryzen 7 2700, and 2700X. April is looking to be a very exciting month in the PC world. With that all caught up, let's get to the builds. First up is the $500 build. For the CPU, I went with the tried and true Intel G4560 for $58. It has 2 cores and 4 threads and has been very difficult to beat in the budget gaming market because it's priced so low. That gives us enough room for a great starter GPU, the GTX 1050 for $170. The 1050 is good for low to medium settings in most games at 1080p, and because it's only a 75-watt card, it can stay cool and quiet. For the motherboard, I went with the Gigabyte GA-B250M-DS3H for $68. It's a micro ATX board, so case compatibility won't be an issue, and it has the 2 main features I look for in any budget motherboard: 4 DIMM slots so you can easily add more RAM in the future, and an M.2 slot for an SSD. For the memory, I picked Kingston's HyperXFURY 2x4GB kit for $95. 8GB is really the minimum you can get away with these days, and since this kit will be paired with an Intel CPU, the relatively slow 2133MHz speed won't have much of a negative effect on performance. For storage, I picked the Seagate BarraCuda 1TB for $45. If you've watched these videos before, you've probably noticed that I recommend this drive with basically every build, and the reason for that is 1TB will cover 99% of people's needs, and it's much cheaper than getting this amount of storage in an SSD. For the power supply, I went with the Thermaltake Smart 500 for $36. For this price, the Smart 500 is hard to beat since it has plenty of wattage for basically any upgrade you might do in the future, it's 80+ rated, and it's actually pretty quiet compared to most budget power supplies. Finally, for the case, I went with the Rosewill FBM-01 for $27. At this budget, the case should really be as inexpensive as possible to free up more for the CPU and GPU, and this one fits the bill while actually looking pretty good. Altogether, these parts come out to $497, just under budget. If you're looking for a strong entry-level gaming build, this one will serve you well. Follow the links in the description to pick up these components. Now, if you have a bit larger budget, I would definitely consider the $750 build to hit that price-to-performance sweet spot. For the CPU, I picked AMD's Ryzen 3 1200 for $100. It has 4 cores and 4 threads, and it's overclockable out of the box. Plus, AMD has promised to support the AM4 socket for the next few years, so you'll have a host of upgrade options now and in the future. The GPU I'm pairing with that is the GTX 1060 3GB for $270. The first time it's been this cheap in quite a while. The 1060 3GB is a beast for 1080p gaming and can easily handle high settings in pretty much any game. Plus, despite being such a powerful card, it runs pretty cool and quiet at idle, so you don't have to deal with your computer sounding like a jet engine. For the motherboard, I went with MSI's B350M Pro-VDH for $75. It's got all you need in a Ryzen motherboard: 4 DIMM slots to upgrade memory later, an M.2 slot for an SSD, which we'll be using, and because it has the B350 chipset, you'll be able to overclock the Ryzen 3 1200. For the memory, I went with the Corsair Vengeance 2x4GB kit for $103. This memory is clocked a little faster at 2400MHz, which should help with performance since Ryzen CPUs are really dependent on memory speeds. For the SSD, I picked ADATA's SU800 128GB M.2 drive for $47. At this price, it's a no-brainer to use this SSD as the Windows boot drive, which helps out significantly with boot times and system responsiveness. Bulk storage again goes to the Seagate BarraCuda 1TB drive for $45. Easy choice. Power will come from Corsair with their CX650M for $65. 650 watts is more than enough for this build, it's 80 plus bronze rated for efficiency, and best of all, it's semi-modular. Being able to pick and choose only the power cables you need makes cable management significantly easier and helps to keep things cool and quiet by improving airflow. Finally, for the case, I picked the Cooler Master N200 for $45. It comes with two 120mm fans, front and rear, and almost the entire front panel is mesh. That's great news for airflow compared to a lot of recent case designs. These parts come out to exactly $750 total. If you're wavering between the $500 and $750 build, I'd definitely recommend this one. The AM4 platform will allow you easy upgrades for several years, and the GTX 1063GB is a very strong contender in the GPU realm. Click the links in the description to pick up these parts for yourself. If you have a bit more to throw at a PC right now, the $1,000 build may be more your speed. For the CPU, I went with AMD's Ryzen 5 1600 for $176. It's a 6-core, 12-thread beast that runs at 3.6 GHz stock, and like all other Ryzen CPUs, it can be overclocked out of the box. Because it comes with the impressively strong Wraithspire cooler, you'll have some hefty overclocking headroom without needing an aftermarket cooler. For the GPU, I went with the GTX 1060 6GB for $350. The 6GB model should give a longevity boost over the 3GB model because it has twice the VRAM, and it actually has a slightly stronger GPU, despite sharing the same 1060 name. For the motherboard, I went with ASUS's Prime X370A for $125. It has the usual 4 DIMM slots for upgradable memory and an M.2 slot for an SSD, and this motherboard comes with plenty of extra features. Maybe the most important is the beefier heat sinks for the VRMs, very useful for stability if you're overclocking. For the memory, I went with Corsair's Vengeance 2x4GB kit for $110. Higher-end builds deserve higher-end memory, and this kit is rated for 3000MHz, great for getting the most out of your Ryzen CPU. For the SSD, I picked ADATA's SX7000 128GB M.2 drive for $60. It's an NVMe drive, which means peak transfer speeds are significantly higher than a SATA drive, which can help with boot and load times. Bulk storage goes to the Seagate BarraCuda 1TB for $45. For the power supply, I picked Seasonic's Focus Gold 550 for $70. It's a semi-modular power supply to make cable management easier, comes with an 80 plus gold efficiency rating, and comes with a huge 7-year warranty. Plus, in my testing of the 450 watt model, this thing is very close to silent even under load. Last but not least, I went with the NZXT S340 mid-tower case for $63. These cases come in quite a few colors to suit your fancy and give you plenty of options for liquid cooling if you want to go that route. Altogether, these parts come to $999, right under budget. This build should last you quite a while without needing any upgrades, and when you do decide to swap out the CPU or add more memory, it'll be easy to do. Click the links in the description to pick up these parts. So that's it for the April edition of Monthly Builds. If you're building a PC for the first time, welcome to the community, and be sure to check out my build videos to see how it's done. If you're a veteran and just needed to catch up, I hope these recommendations helped you. If you want to get notified of new videos as soon as they're up, hit subscribe, then click the bell icon to enable notifications. So guys, if you like this video, hit the like button. If you want to see more, hit subscribe, and if you have any questions on these builds or the parts I chose, leave them in the comments below. Thanks for watching, I hope I helped, and I'll see you in the next video.